While America might have had Elvis, Australia had Johnny O'Keefe. The rock and roll legend wrote and performed a heap of hits, and now his daughter, Vicky, is carrying on his incredible legacy. Craigie Bennett caught up with her.
The fabulously talented Vicky O'Keefe is the daughter of a legend. That is the late, great Johnny O'Keefe, who was Australia's first king of rock and roll.
Vicky O'Keefe, it is a joy to be with you.
Thank you very much.
Your father really created rock and roll in Australia, didn't he?
Yes, he started it all.
Is it true that your dad began his professional life as a Johnny Ray impersonator?
That's true, yeah. And he used to have the little squeeze thing with the water in it where the drops would come out of his eyes, a little like cloud that cried.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock.
The hugely charismatic Johnny became an international singing sensation, but his career began in a most unlikely way.
What really got him going, though, in rock and roll was that movie, The Black Ford Jungle, 1955, Bill Haley and his Comets with That's Rock right. Around the Clock. Is that what inspired your
yes,
dad to do the rock and roll stuff?
And Dad did a concert with him in the early 70s, and I remember meeting him backstage, and it was amazing. But at that time, I didn't realise how powerful and how much Bill meant to Dad.
In 1956, Johnny formed Australia's first rock and roll band, the DJs. By 1960, he had become the most successful singer in Australian music history.
My dad was a great songwriter and co-wrote The Wild One. Well, I'm just out of school, back up real, real cool. Gotta shake,
gotta jive, got the message that I gotta be alive. Wild One was the first homegrown rock song to chart in Australia.
Wild Child.
And found a huge fan in Iggy Pop, whose cover you may recognise from Late Night ABC.
He was very flamboyant on stage. But when the door was shut for you and your two brothers, what was he like at home?
He was quiet. I think there's two sides to a performer. Obviously, you're not always going to be on the top. When you're on the roller coaster, you've got to go down, and you do have to have those quiet moments. We used to go into this tiny little room and watch and have fantails and chips and watch TV, and that was his way of unwinding. I think Dad needed to have a balance in his personality with the assistance of some prescribed medication to help him go to sleep at night and to help him manage his life. Well, I saw a pretty little girl
walking down the street. At times, Johnny had a reputation for being a wild one himself.
In those days, though, it was a little bit frowned upon, and people sort of made a little bit of fun of him from what I can remember at school, and used to sort of get a bit confused with that and think that he was a party animal and, you know, and loved drugs and stuff like that, which wasn't really the case.
Johnny's mental health was seriously rattled following an horrific car crash in 1960.
He was lucky to come out of that alive, wasn't
he? Was, yeah.
Driving from here on the Gold Coast, where we are, one of his favourite places, back to Sydney.
Well,
what happened?
I'm assuming that he fell asleep. He would have been tired. It was after a show. But I've got the photographs in my grandmother's scrapbook of that accident. It's very difficult for me to look at. He was very frail after that, and I think his commitments with television and live work and his young family were very, very difficult to fathom.
Johnny O'Keefe's shock death in 1978, he was only 43, made headlines right around the world.
Do you remember where you were when the news came through that he'd passed?
I do. I was in school. I was called out of the classroom, and I knew there was something was wrong, because when we got to the principal's office, Mum was there and tears were just streaming down her face. And I remember that was the longest car trip to the hospital to say goodbye to Dad. It was terrible. Thank
you. I thank you.
Thank you.
I thank you.
Thank you.
For all this tenderness.
In 2004, a statue was erected on the Gold Coast in his honour.
Well, now, Vicky, this must be a wow. There is your dad, bronzed. You must feel so proud.
So very proud, yes, and it's a pleasure to be able to share this with everybody and be here with you today, Craig. How about we go for a spin in the hot rod?
Well, you've got
Ooh.
Me.
Move, baby, move. Get in the groove now, move.
To keep her father's legacy alive and flourishing, Vicky tours the country with her tribute show, The Johnny O'Keefe Story.
When Dad went over to America all those years ago, he had a number one hit with It's Too Late, She's Gone in New Orleans.
It's too late, she's gone.
To get your song played on the radio in Australia is a feat in itself, let alone...
In America?
Get a number one with it as
wow.
well.
Wow, and he had a gold record too in America, didn't he?
That's the missing gold record that we are trying to locate.
So you're on a mission?
I am on a mission to find that gold record, and I will find it.
You left me all
Vicky has an EP on the way and has just released Standing in the Rain, a song she penned back when she was just 17.
That song, you know, over the years has always been really popular in my live performances. We tried to cut demos of it over the years, but it never really got that attention that it deserved.
Grieving gets stronger.
Knowing now that I wrote it when Dad left, it was so easy to complete the song.
You left me all alone.
Your dad would be so proud of you, Vicky.
I hope so.
Do you feel your father around you now, championing your career?
I do, yes, all the time. I mean, there's so many signals, and especially on stage when I'm performing, you know, having him up there on the big screen, I definitely feel him with me all the time.
Girl, you make me wanna shout, throw my head up and shout.
You've got to make the most of your life and enjoy the times that you have and enjoy every little experience that you have. Like, it's been a wonderful time chatting with you, Craig. I so appreciate you having me on the show, and just everything, you know, saving your moments.
A little bit louder now, 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 yeah, 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 yeah,
if you're liking what we're putting down, if you're liking the merchandise, subscribe here.
And to see more videos in this series, go here.